Another important question frequently asked in the written exam, costodiaphragmatic recess. It is a cleft-like potential space. Costodiaphragmatic recess is a cleft-like potential space between the lower limit of the pleural sac and the lower border of the corresponding lung. Importance is allow expansion of the lung in full inspiration. It is the most dependent part of the pleural sac. If fluid appears in the pleural sac, it collects fast in the costodiaphragmatic recess. Nerve supply of pleura. The costal and peripheral part of the diaphragmatic pleura are supplied by intercostal nerve. The mediastinal pleura and central part of the diaphragmatic pleura are supplied by phrenic nerve. The visceral pleura is supplied by the autonomic nervous system, thoracic 4 to 5 segment of the spinal cord. This is the diagram of the costodiaphragmatic recess. Development of pleura. The parietal pleura develops from the somatopleuric layer of the lateral plate mesoderm, so it is supplied by somatic nerve. Parietal pleura is pain sensitive. The visceral pleura is developed from the splenopleuric layer of the lateral plate mesoderm, so it is supplied by the autonomic nerve. Applied anatomy, pleurisy. Inflammation of the pleura is known as pleurisy or pleuritis. Pleural effusion, accumulation of significant amount of fluid in the pleural cavity is called pleural effusion. Pneumothorax, presence of air in the pleural cavity. Hemothorax, presence of blood in the pleural cavity. Hydropneumothorax, presence of both fluid and air in the pleural cavity. Emphyema is the presence of pus in the pleural cavity. Lungs. The lungs are a pair of respiratory organs situated in the thoracic cavity. Each lung invaginates into the corresponding pleural cavity. The right and left lung are separated by the mediastinum. Features. Each lung presents an apex, base, three surfaces: costal surface, diaphragmatic surface, and medial surface. Medial surface is divided into mediastinal part and vertebral part. Three border: anterior border, posterior border, and sharp inferior border. And right lung presents two fissure. One is oblique fissure, another one is horizontal fissure. This is the oblique fissure and another one is horizontal fissure. And three lobe: upper lobe, middle lobe, and lower lobe. In left lung, there is one oblique fissure and two lobe: upper lobe and lower lobe. Hilum of the right lung contain right principal bronchus, pulmonary artery, and superior and inferior pulmonary vein. This is from above downwards, and before backwards, pulmonary vein, artery, and bronchus. In case of left lung, the relation of hilum is from above downwards, pulmonary artery, left principal bronchus, and pulmonary vein. From before backwards, pulmonary vein, pulmonary artery, and bronchus. These are the features of the lungs. Bronchial tree. The trachea is bifurcated at the level of the lower border of the fourth thoracic vertebra into right and left principal bronchus. Then principal bronchus enter into the hilum of the lung and it divided into lower bronchus, enter the lobes of the lung. Three in number in right lung and two in the left lung. Then lower bronchus divided into segmental bronchus, which enter the segments of the lung. In right lung, there are 10 in number, and left lung, these are the 8 in number. Segmental bronchus, then it branches into bronchial, terminal bronchial, then respiratory bronchial. Up to the terminal bronchial, this is the conducting part. From respiratory bronchial, then alveolar duct, atria, alveolar sac, and alveolus. This is the respiratory portion of the lung. Relation on the mediastinal surface of the both lung. This is another important written question. You have to draw the figure and show the relation. In case of right lung, there are impressions for the right brachycephalic vein and right and left brachycephalic vein joined to form superior vena cava. Here is the impression of the superior vena cava, then inferior vena cava, right subclavian artery, impression for the first rib, arch of Ajax vein, esophagus. These are the impression found on the mediastinal surface of the right lung. Relation on the mediastinal surface of the left lung. This includes left subclavian artery, left brachycephalic vein, impression for the first rib, arch of aorta, descending thoracic aorta, esophagus. These are the relation on the mediastinal surface of the left lung. Another important question is the bronchopulmonary segment. Structurally separated, functionally independent area of the lung aerated by tertiary or segmental bronchus is called bronchopulmonary segment. Question is the define bronchopulmonary segment, draw and label bronchopulmonary segment of the right or left lung, write down its importance. Definition is the structurally separated, functionally independent area of lung aerated by tertiary or segmental bronchus is called bronchopulmonary segment. You have to draw the diagram, both right and left lung. This is the diagram of the bronchopulmonary segment. Importance is that the fibroareolar septa between adjacent segment act as natural barrier and prevent the spread of infection from the one segment to the another. Another important question is artery supply of the lung. The lung gets nutrition from two sources. Conducting part up to the beginning of respiratory bronchiole is supplied by the bronchial arteries and respiratory part is supplied by the pulmonary artery. Right lung usually possesses one bronchial artery and left lung two bronchial artery. Each bronchial artery arises from the descending thoracic aorta. Nerve supply of the lung, sympathetic from thoracic 4 or 5 segment of the spinal cord. It causes bronchodilation and vasoconstriction. Parasympathetic from vagus. It causes bronchoconstriction, vasodilation and secretomotor to the bronchial gland. Difference between right and left lung is it presents two fissure, three loop, and left lung presents one fissure, two loop. Anterior border, difference of the anterior border in case of left lung, there is presence of cardiac notch and lingula. Lingula represents the middle lobe of the right lung. Development of lung. Each lung is developed from the lung bud, which arises from the distal end of the laryngotracheal tube at the ventral wall of the foregut. Each lung bud passes through three stages of development. Glandular stage, it persists up to third month of fetal life and consists of solid collection of cells. Canalicular stage, it extends from 3 to 4th month. During this period, bronchial tree ramify within the bud and blood vessel grow over them. Alveolar stage, alveoli sprout from the bronchial tree and are surrounded by capillary plexus and surfactant fluid appears within the alveoli. This period appears at about 7 months of fetal life. So 7 months is considered as the viable age of the fetus. If type 2 alveolar epithelial cell does not release surfactant, newborn develop respiratory distress syndrome or hyaline membrane disease. Surfactant lower the surface tension, prevent collapse of the lung. There are three